Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good evening to everyone. Welcome to CITREX 2021. I'm Hilmi from the FCKMA UMP. Would like to present my innovation entitled Polymeric Spinal Cage developed via CTFEA. Four main contents will be discussed in this presentation. Let's start with the introduction. We are all very aware about the current pandemic COVID-19. I believe everyone are struggling to adapt with the new norms such as wearing masks, controlled movement, and also working from home. Looking at these images, most of you must understand that the coronavirus is a kind of silent killer. But wait, why did I write killers with an S? Before I answer this question, let me ask you one simple question. In daily average, how long have you been sitting to do work at home or office? 8, 10, or 12 hours? A research done on 2019, for the typical person, more than half of their day is spent only for sitting. The normal office worker sits a shocking of 15 hours every single day. Sitting can badly affect our health in many ways. Most of the major problems come from our back. In the United States, 3.5 million people suffer from moderate and severe degenerative intervertebral disc disease. Poor posture while sitting compressed spinal disc, often leading to chronic back pain and worse, premature degeneration of disc. The pandemic COVID-19, which hit us at the beginning of 2020, clearly changed our way of working. From sitting to more sitting, we can expect more people are going to spend their time and money to treat spinal-related diseases. Too much or longer than 8 hours of sitting will increase the risk of getting any musculoskeletal pain and spinal disease. Spinal cage fusion, or also known as lumbar interbody fusion, LIF, is an alternative treatment for degenerative spinal diseases when conservative treatment fails. By inserting the interbody cages in between the affected lumbar, it will provide instant stability and limit motion at the bone graft site. Spinal cage structures is developed based on the CT images of patients. However, many studies reported post-operative complications associated with conventional cages. For example, stress shielding, device-related osteopenia, and subsidence. Talking about the fabrication of spinal cage, recent advance in additive manufacturing and biomaterial had allowed the usage of 3D printing for fabricating spinal cage and other implants. These are some of the previous studies that has been conducted. In 2002, Wiseman made many experiments by focusing on the biomechanical in vivo study using PLA cage. In 2004, Celine and many other researchers started using homogeneous material properties. Then recently, one of my research partners studied on the comparison of titanium and PEEK cage using CT finite element method. Until recent, no designing and fabrication of polymer cage using CT-based FEM and 3D printing method has been conducted yet. Therefore, in order to gain insight, we had focused on the development of porous PLA design using 3D printing and evaluation using properties for spinal bone in FEA with inhomogeneous material. The main problems that had been identified from the current products can be categorized into three. The first problem is the stress shielding due to the significant difference in the mechanical properties in between the implant and the bone. The second problem is there is no FEA for prediction of implant failure pre-operation. The last problem is the high materials and fabrication costs, which is not equivalent to the value and merits that the patients will get. The product originality is focused on three keywords: optimization, inhomogeneous, and bioresorbable. The current marketed product has not been fully optimized with implementation of porous holes. Second, the implementation of porous structures optimized using CTFEA, which utilize inhomogeneous bone properties. And the third one, bioresorbable material, is used as PLA or polylactic acid. The benefits of using this product would clearly, first one would be the materials which is used is bioresorbable and would be much cheaper, and we can avoid stress shielding. And the last one would be the failed prediction, where using FEA, we are able to predict the cage behavior before it would fail. Our innovation is currently at the concept development stage. We are doing some research by making simulations and experimenting with different optimized spinal cage design. We are expecting to get consistent results before proceeding to the next stage of the experiment, which is in vitro and then in vivo experiment, in order to validate the simulation result. Now, let me explain to you on how the model is going to be made. The inhomogeneous bone properties is very crucial, as it will represent the real spinal bone properties for the simulation. The mechanical properties of the bone model were calculated using Hounsfield unit or HU values from the CT image, where the bone density of each tetrahedral element was defined as the average number of HU units inside each of the corresponding elements. By utilizing the relationship reported by KEAP, the value of Young's modulus, yield stress, and portion ratio were obtained for the heterogeneous bone model as shown in this table. In this section, optimization of cage design was conducted by modeling a bulk cage, namely as closed solid cage design, based on the Telemann cage design. The cage model was imported into finite element and material was defined as PLA. The cages were inserted at the intervertebral located in between the L4 and L5 vertebra using bilateral fixation and standard orientation. The CT data of the spine was obtained from 29 years healthy male subject. The models are loaded with 5 basic spine motion. The finite element result from this analysis are used for designing the optimal spine cage. The optimal spine cage were then fabricated and then tested using compression testing machine. For the fabrication, the material used in this innovation is PLA filament. The integrated strain energy density or SED topology was obtained by integrating all 5 motion activities from the FEM using the closed solid design. Apparently, highest SED marked with the red counter were located obviously at 3 main locations, the top head, middle tail and top side of the model. In optimal design, high density regions or solid structures were properly assigned at this location to support the applied loadings. Meanwhile, unidirectional porous structures were employed at low SED value for optimizing the bone growth and nutrients transportation for bone graft. For optimized design, 2 design parameters were introduced for the top and the side surface of the 3D spinal cage. The parameter of top surface and side surface were defined as closed or open top and solid or porous for the side. 2 different unidirectional pores diameters and 2mm and 1mm were introduced. Total of 6 cages design were created and simulated. We can summarize the whole method using this flowchart. From the CT scan of the patient, we are going to remodel the bone using mechanical finder. For the current study, we are using this software that is capable of defining the bone properties to each element of the 3D model. The fabrication to advantage of the 3D printer based on the fused deposition method or FDM. Now, let's take a look at the marketability and commercialization. PLIF and TLIF procedures are very high, with reported arthrodesis rates between 77% and 100%. In Malaysia, the prevalence of back pain was found to be 12%. 16% or 5.12 million of Malaysia population is 54 years old and above, and this group are very prone to have back pain. The percentage will increase worldwide as lifestyle change due to the pandemic COVID-19. Let's take a look at the cost analysis. Looking at the material, fabrication and overall cost of the conventional products, our products is very superior compared to them. In general, the spinal cage produced using this method will only cost roughly around 20% compared to the conventional spinal cage procedures. The study related to this product had been published in form of journal at 2017, as book in 2020, and this year as a conference proceeding. For everyone for watching and spending your valuable time to watch this video till the end. If you have any questions, you can contact me or you can leave your comment at the comment below.